Hey guys, welcome to the Fame Insider. Now imagine going from being on one of the most watched soapies in South Africa, living the life, to now having to desperately ask for donations because you cannot even afford your rent of 2,500 rands per month. Well, that is the situation that former Generations actor Roderick Jaftha, who played the role of Glen Majozi, finds himself in. Apparently, you guys, things have gotten so bad that he cannot even afford to pay a rent of 2,500 rands, which is for a single room in which he stays with his wife and four children. He has said that, you know, finding gigs has been particularly hard for him, especially because he only speaks two languages, being English and Afrikaans, and he spoke to Zimoja just to give some context when it comes to his current situation. This is what he said: "I don't even have food for my kids today, so I'm trying to run around." Things became worse for him when his wife actually also lost a job. He went on to say, "I'm struggling to pay rent. I have small kids and two of them are still in school. Since I only speak Afrikaans and English, it is hard for me to get roles. I've been getting gigs, but nothing significant." He also went on to explain that he did try to write to Minister Gayton McKenzie, but unfortunately he has not received a response yet. And guys, I'm just thinking, you know, that especially when you are in the entertainment industry, yeah, it is not safe to just know English and Afrikaans, especially when you consider the diversity of languages that are spoken by the South African audience or people that watch soapies. Now, of course, you can get away with knowing just English and Afrikaans in corporate. In fact, that is an advantage. You guys know those applications, right, where they like English and Afrikaans non-negotiable. You must be able to write and read it fluently, and we know who they're looking for those jobs. But anyway, story for another day. But unfortunately, things have been quite hard for him when it comes to getting gigs on the screen, and he has now resorted to asking for donations. And I just can't even imagine how humbling and unfortunate of an experience that has to be, going from, you know, being someone on TV on Generations. Guys, that used to be big. Like, if you're on Generations, like, you had sort of made it as an actor in South Africa, to now not even being able to pay 2.5 for rent. Oh my goodness, I don't even know how things are going to change when it comes to his situation. But I just hope, you know, that some people will donate to him. But also, you know, when it comes to our actors or people just in the entertainment industry in general, I think they really need to be taught, you guys, how to invest for the future. Because unfortunately, we are seeing a number of our actors, a number of our musicians finding themselves in similar situations. And it's just quite unfortunate, especially when you think of the state of the economy right now. People, you know, don't really have extra or disposable income like that to be looking after people who have families and kids and, you know, kids and wives. And it's like, yo, people have their own situations to take care of. And now these people that you used to see on the screen living the life are now begging for donations. But anyway, we hope that, you know, someone will help him out, or someone from a production company or something like that, just so at least he can be able to sustain himself and his family.